We invite you to pray with us as part of the Daily TV Mass community. Our daily devotional email connects you with a link to the day's Mass and a spiritual reflection. To join, please visit our website or call our office at 1-888-383-6277 for more information.
From the historic Loreto Abbey Chapel, with the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Myl. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from three donors. The first is Joseph de Souza from Toronto, Ontario, in memory of his wife, Lalita de Souza, on the third anniversary of her death. The second are David and Debbie Muse from Bittern Lake, Alberta, for the living and deceased members of the Muse and Fontaine families, and in gratitude for the Daily TV Mass. The third is Elfriede Swago from Waterloo, Ontario, in loving memory of her husband, Richard Swago, who passed away on October 28, 2018, in thanksgiving for all the frontline workers during the pandemic and the souls in purgatory. May the Lord keep them well. Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord, just like Saints Simon and Jude did 2 millennia ago, knowing that they're just weak human beings and that every breath belongs to God, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy for us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us say the Gloria together. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. O God, by who the blessed apostles have brought us to acknowledge your name, graciously grant, through the intercession of the saints Simon and Jude, that the church may constantly grow by increase of the people who believe in you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. You are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are citizens with the saints and also members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the cornerstone. In Christ, the whole structure is joined together and grows into a holy temple in the Lord, in whom you also are built together spiritually into a dwelling place for God. The word of the Lord.
Amen. message goes out through all the earth. The heavens are telling the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims his handiwork. Day to day pours forth speech, and night to night declares knowledge. Their message goes out through all the earth. There is no speech, nor are there words. Their voice is not heard. Yet their voice goes out through all the earth, and their words to the end of the world. Their message goes out through all the
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went out to the mountain to pray, and he spent the night in prayer to God. And when day came, he called his disciples and chose 12 of them, whom he also named apostles: Simon, whom he named Peter, and his brother Andrew, and James, and John, and Philip, and Bartholomew, and Matthew, and Thomas, and James, son of Alphaeus, and Simon, who was called the Zealot, and Judas, son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. Jesus came down with them and stood on level place with a great crowd of his disciples, and a great multitude of people from all of Judea and Jerusalem and the coast of Tyre and Sidon. These multitudes had come to hear him and to be healed of their diseases, and those who were troubled with unclean spirits were cured, and all in the crowd were trying to touch him, for power came out from him and healed all of them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today's saints, Saint Simon and Jude, actually we know very little about them, and Simon is not Simon. Simon is not Peter, who Jesus named Peter, and Judas. They call him Jude, because to differentiate him from Judas Iscariot, the traitor. But we know very little about them, and tradition has, and the different sources, either they were martyred in Beirut or Persia, but we really know very little about them. And this is also our destiny as future generations go on, as we go to God. Very little will be known about us, just like these apostles. We just will be names somewhere in a registry, and people might know a few things, but very little. I have a brother in my community who very much is in the genealogy, going back all these generations. And you know, my fifth generation back, he was this important person and that. And But in the end, it's only names. It doesn't mean much. But in the meantime, we are also called to be apostles. We are. Through baptism, we are baptized priest, prophet, and king in Jesus Christ. And we are called to evangelize. But evangelization has to start with ourselves. Apostle, one who is sent. We are also sent through baptism. And so we are sent usually where we are. But to be sent has starts with ourselves. We have to come with in touch with our own self, who we are. My genealogy, I'm just from peasant stock, so not too much of a genealogy there, and no important people. But it starts to with ourselves. Who am I in God? Can I be satisfied with myself, who I am? And as I was praying with this, I really had to think of the 12-step movement who used the prayer at meetings. They start off with the serenity prayer. And actually, they usually use just a very short snippet. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. The serenity to be peaceful with ourselves, the serenity to be comfortable with what we have and who we are. It is so easy in our human nature to look over the fence and say, the neighbors have something I don't have, or this person is more important than I am, to come in touch with our own life and our own weaknesses, our own shadows, but also our own strengths. And to have the courage to change the things I can. Usually it is about ourselves, coming in touch with our own shadows, our own shortcomings. And the more we come in touch with that, the more we can work on those weaker sides of ourselves. The more I can work on my own weak sides. And the more we understand ourselves who we are in God, the more we're more comfortable, the more we will be instruments of peace for people around us. And so this is our human calling as apostles in Christ. But it's a long story, a lifelong story. And it's often, especially, I use this prayer from the 12-step movement, and especially Alcohol Anonymous. But the story they walk is often very much the story we walk. We might not be struggling with an addiction, but it's always about coming in touch with ourselves and putting God first. Who am I in God? Who am I in God? And that can take a lifetime. Who am I in God? And to be comfortable in our own shoes, not to be judgmental of others. There's an old saying, don't judge anyone until you walk the mile in their shoes. To be acceptable, acceptance of everyone around us, and not to try to change the people around us. It is so easy, especially in marriages and family relationships, or even at work. If this person just thought the way I did, then things would be good. Well, they won't be. Nobody will think like I do, or like someone else will think. And this is our story, the story of as we go on through salvation history, as we in the footsteps of Simon and Jude, who are all, we're also unknown, but we're all on the road to God, together, hand in hand, praying for one another, holding one another's hands, especially when things are tough, to be there for someone who's struggling, but also to be open when we are struggling. When I'm struggling, that there's other people to encourage me. And this is our long journey. And this all fits in also with Pope Francis, the prayer for evangelization he has this month. And I just will end with that prayer of Pope Francis. With Pope Francis, we pray this month that every baptized person may be engaged in evangelization, available to the mission by being witnesses of a life that has the flavor of the gospel. we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And so with Pope Francis, we ourselves are called to change ourselves and to be people to evangelize as we go on through salvation history. We also pray for all those in the Daily TV Mass community who have asked to be included in our prayer intention book, especially for our students and all who support them, that they experience the love of Christ and also bring that love into the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all our benefactors and their personal intentions who graciously support our TV Mass community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the reposed souls of all those who have gone before us, especially those who have died of a drug overdose. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for these prayers, and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities, cleanse me of my sins. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of Holy Church.
As we venerate the perpetual glory of the holy apostles Simon and Jude, O Lord, we ask that you receive our prayers and lead us to worthy celebration of the sacred mysteries through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very suffering are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give a door to their faith. To their endurance, you grant them a firm resolve. And in their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing in one song in adoration. And we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as you celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, the other bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the
glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart, as though you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen. Let us join together in this prayer to Saint Joseph. Hail, guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary. To you, God entrusted his only Son. In you, Mary placed her trust. With you, Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a father and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen.
And let us pray. Having received the sacrament, O Lord, we humbly implore you in the Holy Spirit that what we do to honor the glorious passion of the apostles Simon and Jude may keep us ever in your love through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
And we end with a solemn blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow your heads, and your response is Amen. May God, who has granted you to stand firm on apostolic foundations, graciously bless you through the glorious merits of the holy apostles Simon and Jude. Amen. And may he who endowed you with the teachings and example of the apostles make you, under their protection, witness to the truth before all. Amen. And may, through the intercession of the apostles, you may inherit the eternal homeland, for by their teaching you possess firmness of faith. Amen. Amen. And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.
Praise my soul, the King of heaven. To his feet thy tribute bring. Ransomed, healed, restored, forgiven. Evermore his praises sing. Hallelujah.